Welcome to Let's Build This. My name is David, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to design these parts easily in Fusion 360. The parts we're building are a door latch mechanism for this Avid Flyer Mark IV. It's a bush plane that I'm building. So let's get started. Throughout the video, I'll reference these parts that I've already designed previously, and we'll start with this interior door latch. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go into sketch mode. It's here in the top left. I'll select the right side plane. And I'll use the center point circle tool to design my center radius. This will fit around a screw post that is 7.9 millimeters. So we'll go ahead and set that. And then the outer radius of the handle, I'm gonna set that at 22 millimeters. The next part I'm gonna design is the bottom latch part. So I'm gonna set an offset from this edge that's 4 millimeters. I'll use the rectangle tool to grab this point, and then I'll set that at 8 millimeters by 40 millimeters. The next part I want to design is the top handle part, and I want that to have a nice sweeping curve. So I'll grab my center point circle tool, and I'll select this point that is off to the right of the part, and I'll drag that circle until it contacts the part. I'll create another circle that is offset from the original circle, and that'll create this nice converging sweep. And I'll do this a few times so that it's got the right size and the right curve and all of that. The next thing we need to do is to close off the top edge of this handle. I'll grab the two-point circle tool. I'll select this left edge here, and then I'll just drag it to the right edge, and that will create a nice radius over the top. The last thing to do is to shape off this sharp edge. I'm gonna use the arc tool, the three-point arc, and I'll select this top left corner. I'll drag that up to the handle area, and then I'll pull that out till it's got a nice radius. Now that all that's done, I'm gonna grab all the areas that I wanna extrude. I'll hit E on my keyboard, and then I'll extrude that out 7 millimeters, which is the thickness of the part that I want. So now you can see I've got this nice smooth shape to the handle. The next thing I'll do is grab my fillet tool, and I'm gonna radius out these sharp points. I'll first do this top one. I'll drag that to where it looks nice. I'll do the same thing over here on this one, and I'll smooth out the bottom edge of the latch as well. Now we need to create this knob part that sticks out of the top part of the handle. And so to do that, I'm gonna create a new sketch. I'll create it for my new part, which will take on the shape of that part. And the only thing I need to do here is to grab the two-point circle, and then we'll drag it here from this left edge to this right edge. And then I'll grab those two parts and extrude them. We'll set that to a height of 16 millimeters, and we can adjust this later as we need. This next step is an important one to do at this stage. We're gonna wanna add some draft to this part so that it's easy to pull out of the mold. So I'll go ahead and select my draft tool. I'll select this back edge and then the side, and then I'll adjust that draft out until it looks right. So I'm gonna set this at -5 degrees. All right, and let's actually shorten the height of this knob just a little bit. Let's smooth out this other part here by grabbing the fillet tool, and we'll drag that out so it's got a nice smooth transition. I'll fillet out all the sharp edges here, and you sometimes have to try an edge. If the geometry doesn't work super well, you may have to change the order in which you do them to get the right look and feel. The last part is I want this post to be recessed into the handle just a little bit. So I'm gonna grab the cylinder tool. I'll go ahead and select the center point. I'll drag that out to the radius of the post, and then I'll cut that in 1.25 millimeters. And we'll also radius this outside edge as well. Next part, I'm gonna go ahead and put the hardware in here just so we've got everything dimensionally accurate. I've already designed these parts before, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull a reference off of these, and then we'll create a new set. And this is pretty straightforward. We're just gonna use the cylinder tool. We'll create the initial post, then we'll create the top pin, and I'm just gonna create that at 1.25 millimeters for where it's recessed. And then I'll create an additional piece, and that allows me to add the radius to that part. And then I'll combine all three of those together. The next thing I'm gonna do is cut a hole through the center of my post. Then we'll go ahead and add a chamfer onto this inside edge. Next, you're gonna hit the create menu and then thread. And then from that sub menu, you're gonna select unified threads. We'll select the number 10 and set that at 1032. Now for the screw, it's basically the same process, but from an outside diameter. To create this cut in for this hex key, we're actually gonna create a new sketch from the top of the screw. And then we'll go ahead and select our polygon tool, select our center point, and then we'll drag that down 2 millimeters, which actually is a 4 millimeter Allen key. And let's go ahead and name all these parts so that we can keep everything organized. The next piece we're going to design is this outside knob. So we'll go ahead and create a new sketch. We'll go ahead and create that from the outside edge of the post. We're first going to use the circle tool to draw out the height of the knob. So we'll set that at 14 millimeters. Then we'll set the center radius at 5 millimeters, which will allow the screw to go through it. And when I build this knob, I want the front end to be shorter than the back end of it. So I'm gonna grab the line tool from our center point. I'll draw that out 24 millimeters. And on the back end, I'll go 40 millimeters. And this will give me a point to grab a circle on the front end. We'll make that 8 millimeters and then 6 millimeters on the back end. Next, we're gonna grab that arc tool again. We'll grab this top radius over to this front circle. And I like to go past it just a little bit. And the reason I do that is so that I've got a nicer edge to fillet out. I'll show that to you in just a moment. And you can now see that we've got a nice airfoil shape to it. Also, when I design, I sometimes like to do it in a symmetrical mode where I'll design just half of the part so I can do all my featuring all on that single half. And then I'll be able to mirror the part later. And so it saves me a little bit of time on having to do all the different features on both sides. And in order to do that, I'm gonna take the line tool and I'm gonna cut each of these circles in half. Let's go ahead and select all the profiles for this top half. And I'll include these slivers in there for now just to show you what this will look like. Now, if I go fillet this out, you can see that even though it comes out pretty smooth, it still has a little bit of a bow into it. And so in order to not do that, I'm gonna actually undo all this. I'll select all those profiles, but I'm not gonna include those slivers. And you can see that makes a little sharp point here at each edge. And now when I go fillet this out, it's gonna fillet out an outside edge instead of that inside edge. Now we'll go back into the create menu, we'll select mirror, we'll select our part, and then we'll select this bottom edge and mirror that part. And then we'll radius this back edge here, get rid of that point, and we'll do the same thing here on the front end as well. The next thing we're gonna wanna do is add a recess for either side of this where the screws will go through. So we'll take the cylinder tool, we'll set those at the correct dimensions according to the screw and at the correct depth. And I'll move this part around as I need to get it in the right spot. Now we need to also add draft to this part as well so that it's easy to take out of the mold. And we'll adjust that draft. I think we'll set this at -3. And the only thing left to do on this part is to just fillet out all those edges to make them nice and smooth. All right, the last part to create is this mount. So to do that, I'll go ahead and select sketch. We'll go ahead and select our plane. And we'll draw the center radius. We'll set that at 8 millimeters. This will give us a little bit of room in between that post and the mount so that the part's able to rotate. We'll set the outer radius of the mount. We'll set that again at 22 millimeters so it's got a nice match to it. The next thing I'm gonna do is take the line tool and I'm gonna draw from the center point. I'm gonna come down 16.5 millimeters and this is gonna give me the correct height for the mount. We'll select our rectangle tool and then we're gonna draw a rectangle that's 46 millimeters at 3 millimeters. And the only thing left to do here now is to radius out these two corners. So we'll select our fillet tool, and then we'll just select each one of these edges. We'll radius that out to 3 millimeters. And when you do that, it deletes one of these lines. So we'll just draw that line back in on the left side. And we'll go ahead and radius that out as well. And the only last thing to do with this is we just need to select all of our parts. We'll extrude that out 10 millimeters. We'll go ahead and move this over by 2 millimeters. And the only thing left to do on this is I'm gonna cut out this little part on the bottom. The latch, as it rotates in place, it pushes against the post. So I'm gonna have this little cutout in there. So go ahead and drag this circle out until it contacts the part. I'll cut the part. All right, there you have it. So I now have these three different parts made. And so if you want to see what I'm doing with these, I'm actually going to be building these parts out of forged carbon. I'll be 3D printing molds to make these. And so you can actually find that next video right here.